Hi everyone, I'm Amanda and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to show you how to make this gorgeous crochet baby blanket. The finished size of this baby blanket is 24 by 28 inches, which is around 61 by 71 centimeters. In the tutorial, I'll show you how to crochet the pique stitch, which is a special type of cluster stitch. It's really easy to do. It's not difficult at all. It creates a really lovely texture. And you'll finish the blanket off by working two rounds of half double crochet. And if you like, you can attach a pom-pom into each corner of your blanket. If you like written patterns, I have a free written pattern on my blog. I'll put the link to that below the video in the description box. This baby blanket is part of a set consisting of a little hat, a baby cardigan, and a pair of little baby booties. I'll put links to all of these tutorials below the video in the description box. To make this baby blanket, I used a worsted weight, also known as an Aran weight yarn. I decided to use Derrimore's Studio Anti-Pilling Aran, which is a really lovely soft yarn with a lovely drape. If you're making the blanket, you'll need three balls. If you would like to make four pom-poms, one for each corner, then you'll need one extra ball. So that would be four balls in total. For the crochet hook, I used a J hook, which is 6 millimeters, slightly bigger than the recommended size of 5 millimeters, but it gives the blanket a really lovely drape. And you'll also need a pair of scissors. And you'll need a tapestry needle for weaving in your ends. If you would like more details about all the materials I used, have a look below the video in the description box. In today's tutorial, I'll give you instructions to crochet a baby blanket, but if you'd like to practice the stitch pattern and make a small sample, make a chain of 15. Otherwise, for the full-sized baby blanket, start with a chain of 47. And when you're making your chain, it's important that you make sure that it's very loose. I've just finished making my chain and I'm making a small sample, so I made a chain of 15, but if you're making the full-sized baby blanket, you should have a chain of 47. We're now going to begin working on row number one. So to begin this row, you're going to work one special cluster into the fourth chain from the hook. So counting 1, 2, 3, and 4, you're going to work one special cluster into that fourth chain. So to make the special cluster stitch, you're going to yarn over hook, insert your hook into that fourth chain, yarn over, pull up a loop, You'll have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two loops. You'll have two loops on your hook, yarn over, insert your hook back into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have four loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through all four loops. And that's the special cluster stitch. And the three chains that we've just skipped, these count as your first stitch. And then for the remainder of row one, you're going to work one special cluster into each chain until you have one chain remaining. So I'll show you again. Yarn over hook, insert your hook into the next chain, yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have three loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through two loops. You'll have two loops on your hook, yarn over, insert your hook back into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. You'll have four loops on your hook, yarn over, and pull through all four loops. And there's your second special cluster stitch. So as I say, for row one, you're going to work one special cluster into each chain. Until you've got one chain remaining. So I'm going to work this off camera and I'll meet you once I've got one chain remaining. I've been working my special cluster stitches all the way along the foundation chain and I've got one chain remaining. So into this last chain, I'm going to work one half double crochet. And that's the end of row number one. So at the end of this row, you should have your skipped three chains here, and then you should have 43 special cluster stitches. And then at the end, you should have one half double crochet. To begin row number two, and this is the row that you're going to be repeating as you work up your baby blanket. So begin by chaining three, one, two, and three, and then turn your work. And the chain three counts as your first stitch. You're then going to work one special cluster into the next 43 stitches. So the next stitch that you work into will be this stitch here. You've got this stitch here, but you've got the chain three coming out of it, and this counts as your first stitch. So the next stitch will be this one here. So work your special cluster stitch. So work your special cluster stitches all the way along the row. Until you have your chain three at the end here. And I'll show you how to work the last stitch. So again, I'll work my special cluster stitches off camera and I'll meet you at the end of row number 2. I've been working my special cluster stitches all the way along the row, and I'm just going to show you how to work the last 2 stitches. So here's my last special cluster here. So I'm going to work a special cluster into the top of this stitch. And then I've got my chain 3 here. Into the top of the chain 3, I'm going to work 1 half double crochet. And that's the end of row number 2. And at the end of this row, you should have your chain 3 at the beginning, and then you should have 43 special cluster stitches. And then at the end, you should have your half double crochet. So for the remainder of this pattern, you're simply going to repeat row number 2. So you'll begin by chaining 3, 1, 2, and 3. Turn your work. And then you'll work 1 special cluster into the next 43 stitches. So your next stitch is this one here. So you'll work your 43 special cluster stitches. And then when you get to the end of the row, you'll work a half double crochet into the top of the beginning chain 3. So once you've worked your 43 special clusters, you'll arrive at the end here. So you'll have your beginning chain 3. Into the top of that chain 3, work 1 half double crochet. So for the remainder of this pattern, repeat row number 2 until you have a total of 47 rows. Once you've finished working your 47 rows, it's now time to start working on the border. So at the end of row number 47, don't turn your work. Instead, we'll begin working down the first side here. So to begin, chain 1, and then into the corner here, we're going to work 3 half double crochet. So I'm just going to work my 3 half double crochet here into this last stitch. So there's 1, 2, and 3. So there's my 3 half double crochet into the corner. And then we're going to begin working into the end of each row. So you've got the first row here, the second, third, and so on. Beginning at the end of the first row, so right in here, you're going to work 2 half double crochet. So there's 1, and then work another half double crochet back into the same spot. And then move along to the next row, and at the end, you're going to work 1 half double crochet. So this is going to be the sequence. You'll work 2 half double crochet at the end of the next row, and then 1 half double crochet at the end of the following row. So 2 half double crochet at the end of the next row, So there's one, and then work another half double crochet into the same place. And then one half double crochet into the end of the following row. So it's two half double crochet at the end, and then one half double crochet at the end of the next row. So you're going to repeat this sequence of stitches all the way down the first side of your baby blanket, and I'll meet you once we get to the next corner here. When you get to the bottom of the first side of your blanket, into the end of the last row here, you're going to work two half double crochet. So there's one and two. And then we're going to work our next corner. So it will be into this first stitch here, and we'll work our three half double crochet into this first stitch, which is our corner as well. So there's one, two, and three. And then working along the bottom of the blanket, which is our foundation chain row, we're going to work the same sequence. So we'll work two half double crochet and then one half double crochet. So into the next stitch, work two half double crochet. So there's one, and then another one back into the same stitch. And then into the following stitch, work one half double crochet. So this is the sequence, two half double crochet into the next stitch, one and two, and then one half double crochet into the following stitch. So repeat this sequence all the way along the bottom of your blanket, and I'll meet you at the next corner. I've arrived at the next corner, and we've got the chain three here. These are the three chains that we skipped at the beginning of row number one. So into the top of the chain three, I'm going to work three half double crochet. So there's one, two, and three. So that's our corner done. And then we'll work up the third side of the blanket. So we've got the first row here. And I'm going to work, instead of doing two half double crochet and then one half double crochet, we're going to start with one half double crochet and then two half double crochet. So at the end of the first row, work one half double crochet and then move to the next row, and at the end work two half double crochet. So there's one and then two. So this is the sequence, one half double crochet and then two half double crochet. So move to the next row, at the end work one half double crochet and then at the end of the next row work two half double crochet. So you're going to repeat this sequence all the way up the third side of your blanket. And again, I'll work this off camera and I'll meet you at the next corner. I've just finished working the third side and I'm going to work my next corner, and I'll work my 3 half double crochet into the top of the chain 3 here. So there's 1, 2, and 3. And then we're going to work along the top of our blanket. So we'll begin working in the first stitch and we're just going to work 2 half double crochet and then 1 half double crochet. So there's 1 half double crochet and then another one back into that first stitch there. And then moving along to the next stitch, I'm going to work 1 half double crochet. So this is going to be the sequence. We'll work 2 half double crochet into the next stitch and then 1 half double crochet into the following stitch. And you're going to repeat this sequence all the way along the top of your blanket until you get to the beginning of the round. I've come to the end and I'm just going to work 1 half double crochet into this first stitch here. And then to join the round, I'm going to come to, so we've got the chain 1 here. I'm going to skip the chain 1 and I'm going to come to the first half double crochet and I'll join into the top of this stitch with a slip stitch. For round 2, we're going to work 3 half double crochet into this first stitch here. So, in fact, I'll begin by chaining 1 and then back into the same stitch, I'm going to work 3 half double crochet. There's number 2 and then 3, and that's our 3 half double crochet into the corner. And then for the remainder of this round, we're just going to work 1 half double crochet into each stitch all the way around the blanket. And when you get to the corners, you'll have your 3 half double crochet. So I've got 1, 2, and 3 in each corner into the middle stitch, into the center stitch. I'll work my 3 half double crochet. So I'm going to work this off camera. So as I say, you just work 1 half double crochet into each stitch all the way around, making sure that you work 3 half double crochet into the center stitch of those 3 half double crochet that you made in the corner. I'll just work one of the corners with you. So I've got 1, 2, and 3, my 3 half double crochet. So into this next stitch, I'll work 1 half double crochet, and then into the next stitch, which is the center stitch, I'll work my 3 half double crochet. So there's 1, 2, and 3, and that's what you'll do in each corner. and then you'll just work your one half double crochet into each stitch along each side. I've come back to the beginning of the round and I'm just going to work one half double crochet into this last stitch here. And then to join the round, I'm going to skip the chain one. So skip the chain one here, and then into the first half double crochet, I'm going to join with a slip stitch. And that's the end of round number two, and that's the end of the main part of your baby blanket. So you just need to cut your yarn and weave your tail ends in. And here's the blanket all finished. I decided to attach a pom-pom to each corner of my blanket. If you would like to see tutorials in how I make and attach my pom-poms, I'll link these videos below. I really hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, please consider giving it a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell icon so you don't miss out on any future videos that I upload. Thanks for watching.